Started on it. When I'm learning to count and get your cool down, make sure you get food in. Delilah, Olivia, Gemma, Zoe. No, I'm not too big. Kaya. Shard. Kylie. Elisa, Zoe D, Leo, Mikhail, Syra, Noah, Emmeline, Mila. Jonathan, Cristiano, Aiden, Anna. stand up when you have this answer. Alright, so this is taking way, way longer than it should. Let's go ahead and go over this. Alright, so Pickawacky converts 16 out of 20 field goal attempts. This breaks record by blank, by making blank percent. Alright, so your first question is to complete the news caption above. Would we need to find the part, the percent, or the whole? Alright, so same thing that we did last week. You're going to stand up whichever section or part that you feel like is, you need to answer the question. Alright, stand up if you pick the part. Okay, stand up if you pick the whole, the percent. Okay, so no need to go any further. You are looking for the percent. And how do you know you're looking for the percent? What was your clue? Delilah?
Because in the newspaper caption, it says breaks record by making blank percent.
Okay. All right, was there anything else? Alright, number three, it says, about what percentage of his field goal attempts do you think Jackie Pickawacky make? Alright, remember, this is an estimate. This is a guess. Okay, so there is no right or wrong answer here. Jonathan?
Eight.
How many?
Eight.
Eight?
Yeah, eight.
You said eight?
80.
80. Alright. So 80%? Alright, what was another one? Troy? 75%. Okay. Anybody else? Nobody else guess? Or you guys all guess either 80 or 75?
I guess
80. Okay. All right. So then those are the two options we have. So now, how did you get your answer for number three? So if you got 80 or you got 75, how did you get that answer? Troy? Okay, all right, Mikhail.
So every four of 20 would be around
So you did kind of like a double number line? Is that kind of what I'm understanding? Okay. Troy, is that something similar that you did? You kind of used the, because you did the same thing, the 20 divided by 4. Okay. All right. Does anybody have a different method other than using a double number line? Okay. I can't hear what you said.
I did the side-to-side.
Side-to-side method? What do you mean?
Like,
so you set it up like this from last week?
Yeah.
And then you put your 100, and you put your X.
Yeah.
All right, so you put 20 here,
yes,
and 16 here?
Yes.
And then you went like this, and like this?
Well, kind of.
Or you went like this, and like this? Okay, all right. Camden, what'd you do?
I basically did that, except instead of showing that, I just multiplied.
Okay, so you just didn't show the setup of it.
I just did 20 times 5 and 16 times 5.
Okay, all right. What'd you get? Or how'd you get your answer?
I just did 20 divided by 2, which is 10, and then 10 goes into 100 easily, so 16 divided by 2 is 8, and 8 times 10 is 80.
Okay. Lots of different ways. I'm not telling you the answer yet. Go ahead, glue this into your notebook. And then get out the note sheet that I just passed out. Oh, and do me a favor. In your title, I want you to highlight that today we're working on percent. And then go to your thing from last week or from Friday and highlight part, because that's the one we focus on. So last week we focused on part, today we're focusing on percent. Our main focus is going to be on finding percent. We're still going to be using one of the proportion equation that will always be there for you to use. So it says problems like the football problem in the warm-up are problems where we are trying to find the what? What are we trying to find? What do we try to find in the warm-up question? Emily?
The percent.
Okay, so, and then again, this is what we're going to be using. So what does the P stand for? What does the P stand for? Aiden?
Part.
What does the W stand for? Mila? What does the symbol stand for?
And that the header always goes in the bottom.
Alright, since we know how to solve proportions, all we need to do is substitute two values. We are given into the proportion and solve for the variable.
All right, so, and the reason I didn't give you the answer to the percent question or the warm-up question today says we're gonna do it here. All right, so it says, for example today, it says 16 is what percent of 20? Determine whether you're looking for the part, the percent, or the whole. And we know that we are looking for our percent. Substitute the two known values into the percent proportion equation and leave a variable in the place for the unknown. All right, so in our equation we do 16, 20, and we don't know what that is. And it says use a percent symbol, but cross it out. All right, step number three. Ooh. Says solve the proportion for the variable, which is your x, using the methods learned in previous units. So you have a couple different options. You have the side-to-side method, or you have the cross-product method. Notice this one, though. This one is important. I want you to actually highlight, circle it with something different other than your pen or your pencil. All right, so the up and down method does not work well with this problem. So that is something that, with your finding percents, might not be the method you want to use. So you can either do the side-to-side method, or you can do the cross-product method. All right, so let's do the side-to-side method. So how do I go from 20 to 100? William?
You multiply it by 5.
Multiply that by 5. So 16 times 5 gives me 80. So that's one way to do it. Okay, you get 80%. Or you can do your cross product over here, which essentially you multiply. You do 16 times 100, which gives you what? That's 16 times 100. Aiden? 1,600. And then you get 20x, which you have to divide by 20, which means you divide by 20, which gives us 80%. Alright, there is another method that is not on this page that I'm going to tell you, or I'm going to show you today also. Okay? So you can also take this number and divide it by that number. So I would do 16 into 20. So 16 divided by 20. And what do I multiply 20 by to get 160? What do I multiply 20 by to get 160? Adeline?
80.
Well, you would get, you'd multiply by 8, and then this becomes 0.8, and then this is where, when you come back from Christmas break, we're gonna learn about fractions, decimals, percents. But to change a decimal to a percent, you move your decimal two places to the right, and you get the same answer. Okay, so this is like the division method. All right, again, just another one you can use. You do not, excuse me, you do not have to at all. I just like to give you guys as many options as possible so that you have one that you like and makes the most sense. All right. Any questions about your notes for today? All right. Go ahead. Glue this into your notebook. Alright, so go ahead and look at your practice problems page. We are going to go over the first one together.
Yeah, there are a couple different
methods you can use. And hopefully you learned from the practice on Friday that not one works the best sometimes. Sometimes you've got to use one, sometimes the other one works, sometimes. So really it's up to you and which one you want to use. Alright, so for this one it says 18 is what percent of 90. So I'm going to set it up in the equation form. So what do we think side to side? How do you think that's going to work? So trying to go from 90 to 100 or 100 to 90, is that going to be very easy? No. Alright. We could cross multiply, right? So you can go this way and this way. Multiply 18 times 10, or 100 times 18, which gives us what? 1,800. And then what do we do with that 1,890? What do we do? You gotta get this process down for cross multiplication. What do you do? Yeah, so then you're gonna divide 1,800 divided by 90. Well, what's 18 divided by 9? Mila? 2, and then I just add my 0. So that's one way to do it. Or I could say, okay, well, 90 divided by what gives me 18? Does anybody know? Mikhail? I'm then going to do 100 divided by 5, and that gives me 20. So either way here, doesn't matter which way you do, still get the same answer. Okay, you guys are doing 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Coming, showing me your work, making sure that you actually have your work on your page and not just arrows, like you've got to show this. I know I didn't show it here, only because I didn't have enough room, but you've got to show your steps. Whichever way you decide to do, you have to show your work. Okay? And then, once you're done with this, if you are not one of my three people, then you can head off. Okay? Yes, you can move around the room. You're not working with anybody. You're working quietly.